Hi, let's see how the spectrophotometer works, and I'm just turning it on here. It takes a couple of minutes to set up. I have just turned it on. Now let me press the power button. It's on, so it's asking us to please wait. Okay, next. So after this I'm gonna click start button here. Okay. So it will take some time to set up here. As you can see, the lights are passing here. Spectrophotometer, it is used to measure the concentration of a solute in the given solvent. So it takes some time to set up. In the meanwhile, we call this as cuvette. So you should make it ready, this cuvette. So this is anyways a zero cuvette, and let me show you how do you need to insert it inside the spectrophotometer. Here, can you see this marking here? It's like a white color triangle. That marking has to be taken care of while inserting this cell inside the spectrophotometer. I'll show you how it has to be inserted. See, this is getting ready in the meanwhile. I hope you can see this. And showing you about talking about the wavelengths. See, the wavelength for ammonia is 425, phosphate is 880. So these are necessary when we operate, when we do some sample testing on ammonia, phosphate, nitrate, etc. Next. Now as you can see, this is ready. Okay, so now see here, right now I'm interested in absorbance, the second one. So why do we need this absorbance? See, we can check the turbidity, we can check the concentration of solutes. So let me go with this one. So see here guys, I'm gonna click on the arrow below. Yeah, so it came on this thing. Now I'll press start. Okay, so this is to start insert cell, it is asking me, but let me set the wavelength. So I'm gonna press F2 here, because this is wavelength. F1 is setup, F3 is transmission. I'm gonna click on F2, which is wavelength. Okay, so it is asking me to set the wavelength. So for example, if I go with ammonia, I have to click 425 nanometer.